you back to 19th century Bavaria for a very sad story about two of my favorite subjects, industrial theft and bazooms. Auto-titling inventor and Kraut had nothing to get very worked up about. His inventions were failures, his future seemed bleak. He fled to the opera at least twice a week. One night at the opera he saw an Aida, whose bust was so big it would often impede her. Bug-eyed, he watched her fall into the pit, dumbed by the weight of those terrible tits. Oh my God, there she blows! Aerodynamically, this girl was a mess. Otto eyeballed the diva lying comatose amongst the reeds, and he suddenly felt the fire of inspiration flood his soul. He ran back to his workshop where he futzed and futzed and futzed. For Otto Titsling had found his quest to lift and mold the female breast, to point the small ones to the sky, to keep the big ones high and dry. Every night he'd sweat and snort, searching for the right support. He tried some string and paper clip. Hey, he even tried his own tulip. Well, he stitched and he slaved and he slaved and he stitched until finally one night in the wee hours of morning, Otto arose from his workbench triumphant. Yes, he had invented the world's first over-the-shoulder boulder holder. Hooray! Exhausted but ecstatic, Otto ran out to the diva bearing the prototype in his hot little hand. But little did Otto know, at the moment of his greatest triumph, lurking under the diva's bed was none other than the very worst of the French patent thieves, Philip de Brazil. And Phil was watching the scene with a great deal of interest. Later that night, while our Aida slept, into the wardrobe Philippe softly crept. He fumbled through knickers and corsets galore till he found Otto's titsling and he ran out the door, crying, oh my God, oh what joy, what bliss! I'm gonna make me a million from this. Every woman in the world will wanna buy one. I will have all the goods manufactured in Taiwan. Ooh. The result of this swindle is pointedly clear. Do you buy a titsling or do you buy a brassiere?
Listen, I've got a racquetball.